a la cultura ya. Se reconoce que hace falta todo. En Cuba el del campo y el de la ciudad tiene el mismo derecho. Te lo gana con tu esfuerzo, tu sacrificio y puedes ir a ejercer cualquier, lo que dé tu capacidad. ¿Entiendes? Importa que sea prieto, importa que sea blanco. La revolución trae de donde esté el que sirve y lo pone en el lugar. ¿Entiendes? Por tanto, si él como pintor sirve, pues como pintor va y da.
On the outskirts of town lives Ramon, another brother of Raul, builder by trade. Quiet by nature, he's always been close to his young brother and spotted his artistic vocation from an early age.
Bueno, yo te diría que Raul desde muy chiquito, Raul se inclinó a la pintura. Porque yo recuerdo que Raul lo primero que empezó a trabajar fue con masilla. En aquel tiempo, vaya, yo pensé que le gustaría eso, pero vaya, no le puse al menos, ¿entiendes? Iniciativas sobre eso. Vaya, solamente pensé que le gustaría eso, ¿no? Pero no, vaya, jamás pensé que le iba a llegar vaya, donde ha llegado. Yo no pensé en eso. Muchacho, orgulloso de mi hermano, ¿eh? Orgulloso. Orgulloso de mi hermano pintor.
A few hours' drive out of town, deep in the rainforest, lies the valley of La Vuelta, where Raul's family used to farm. The journey is an arduous one. After the long drive, when the road ends, there's still several hours of walking on dirt track under the burning sun before reaching destination.
I'm very excited and very happy because it's about 25 years I don't come in here. And I think the place is still beautiful as I saw. It's the most beautiful place in the planet. You know the green field there? It's a palm tree and a mango tree in the green square.
This is Silvano's property. This is his own tree, my father, of mango.
Y es la finca nosotros.
Ya, ya.
Ya, mira.
From the road to the river's hour.
Ah, ese camino. ¿Puedo ver el camino todavía?
Sí, sí, sí. Sí, todavía está ahí.
I can see the road. You can see the road.
Muy alto.
Está
todo
el film.
Ah, sí, mira, 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 mira.
The land of La Vuelta still belongs to Raul's family, although it's now being farmed by close relatives. When Raul's parents were looking after the land, the farm was prosperous. And many families lived in the surrounding areas. Today, most of them have moved to town, and the valley has grown even more poor and isolated. The trip to La Vuelta is extremely important for Raul the artist. There, amongst the luxuriant abundance of palms, mango trees, and coffee plants, lies all the inspiration for his paintings.
My painting started from to be a green, and later they developed between greens and orange, and coming very bright orange, and the orange coming to the red. I use it a lot in my painting, this color. And the reason I do it is not because I want to do it mango. I do it because this mango grow in the earth where I learning to walk. The mythology and the magic in Cuba and the reality, they are very, very intrinsic, very close. They are embroidered. And it's no boundary between reality and dream. And clearly, it's what I am. I'm happy coming back here because even though it wasn't my intention, but I think it's like I will recharge my battery because now I discovered that who I am and the kind of painting I do, everything is who I am, isn't for this place, coming from here.
The Cuban journey started in Havana, and that's where it finishes. While waiting for the plane back to London, Raul has time for a last stroll on the Malecón and some thoughts on the last 2 weeks.
It's very difficult. I leave Cuba once. And I don't feel I leave Cuba now. I remember when, many years ago, I came to this place and spent hours and hours watching this sea and it's in. When I will jump at this. But now I'm here, yeah, it's very funny, you know? I've been there, I've been back again, and I go back again. I'm desperate to go to Solva. Really, really. Because I'm desperate to go, because Solva is the people where I am, the town where I am. My picture waiting for me there.
Raul and Heather have now been back in Solva for a week and are adjusting slowly to their life in Wales. It's already apparent that the changes brought by the journey to Cuba are profound.
What I noticed about him when we first came back was that, to begin with, he was quite chaotic, that it's like he'd picked up the chaos of Cuba and brought it back with him. And that's not necessarily a bad thing, I think. There's more of a feeling of immediacy, perhaps, in what he's doing at the moment. I think it's going to lead to an explosion of work once he's had time to process what he's thinking and feeling, both about his family and about his own country.
All the elements, they are like a memory of the color, or how the color feel like to be in a midday in Cuba. Plus, the color of the forest, you know, the plant and the fruit. In Cuba, the color, they are over the place. They are everywhere. And it's how I feel like coming back from Cuba. I'm very happy with this painting. I'm very happy with this painting. And I seen I would be painting like that for a while.
After years spent running away from his past, Raul is finally beginning to heal the differences that have separated him from his family for so long. Away from the hardship of Cuban existence, he is now starting to find a purpose for his life abroad.
I am like somebody who win lottery. If you get out of Cuba, by the time I get out of Cuba, it's like a win the lottery. No, because even now, it's like to be able to be live outside of Cuba and go back to Cuba and out of Cuba is a miracle. My family feel like, if Cuba go big time into capitalism, at least we have somebody in the family who know what it's all about and could give some kind of guidance or help economic or some kind of orientation like that. Then I'm very happy to do that, really.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Welcome to the Harlem Ringo Night.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
That's good. Brilliant.
The jackpot tonight is £75 on 55 numbers.
Following the chaos of the Cuban journey, Raul is glad to be back in the tight community life of Solva. Being away from Wales for a while has put in sharp focus the deep reasons why he has chosen to live here.
Before I went back to Cuba, I have this kind of weird feeling, that I'm here, what I'm doing here. People come into the gallery and say, what are you doing here? You are from Cuba? And Heather, my wife, still say, when she saw the beach and the sun and the set and the sunset, all of this tropical, and she say, I don't understand why you live in Wales. And I never ask the question myself, why I live in Wales. I know I love Wales, I like to live in here. But I think it's a challenge for me to be living here because I'm not from here, I don't speak in Welsh, I'm in black. And I found this very, very exciting. It's a new culture. I never will stop it to learning something about Welsh people. I know more and more now about Solva. I could see Solva with another eye. No.
From Wales to Cuba, from Cuba to Wales, the quest for identity continues. But for the time being, between sea and sky, the wandering spirit of Raul has found home in Wales. But home doesn't matter for Raul. What really counts is freedom.
I think life is full of sin, like you have to pay your tax. You have to pay the VAT. You have to have the identity card. You have to do that. You have to do that. You have to. Life, even in this country, is very regulated. Art is the only way where you can be free as you possibly could be. Nobody could have the right to interfere. No art critic, no magazine, no Turner Prize, no television programmer. Nobody. This is your place. This is your brain. You do whatever you want to do. What the hell you want to do, that's it.